Hello everyone! Starting with the Rhino 6, Autodesk T-Spline is no longer available for Rhino. So in the old time, this kind of really smooth surface is really easy to achieve in the T-Spline. In the Rhino, we can still make it happen, it just takes a few more steps. Today I'm going to show you from this step, from the red color getting into the purple color. Welcome back to PJ Chen Design Channel. This channel is to share Rhino 3D knowledge to help students and 3D model professionals to learn various Rhino techniques. Are you ready? Let's get started. When we have a model something like that, the intersection look really harsh. If we look at the render view, you kind of see there's a fall line there. In order to make them smoother, one of the way that you can do is to giving the fillet edge is on the top, right, on the all four edges. But before we do that, we need to make sure they are intersect, right? So what I'm going to do is using the trim tool. It's going to holding using this as a cutting tool, and then we want to cut somewhere intersect. So we're going to trim where, you know, on the other side, so it will no longer see from this view. Okay, and then we hit enter again to bring back to previous command, and this time we're going to use those two and to trim off is where is it intersect. So we're going to trim off here and trim off here. So on the bottom there are four different parts, but one you can hit enter and select all of them and join them together. All right, so one of the way to make it look a little bit rounded on those edges, we are going to use the fillet tool. Right here, going to the solid tool, that you will have this fillet edges. And we are going to use a radius for 2. So select all the edges for radius for 2. And then you hit enter. Then you will get something like this. It's not too bad. Let's take a look on the render view. All right. It's not too bad. But instead of one line, you become two line. But you still get some sort of the edge there. Right. The way I'm going to show you is take a few more steps. Let's turn on the final result here. It takes a few more steps to get that. But what is good is like you have really rounded edges, you know, all the way from this edge to the other edges. Okay. So I'm going to delete this guy and starting from the scratch. Let's start building this structure. I'm going to use the rectangular tool and turn on my grid snap, counting about 4 from each side. So 4 from the left, 4 from the right, and coming down here with the same distance. Okay, so that's 1. And then I will just using the gumball, rotate it, holding my shift and hit the Alt key. And then you'll see the plus sign, and that's how we make a copy. Okay, so I select all of them and trim somewhere in the middle. Okay, hit enter. So you got that cross there. We are going to use the same radial as the sample. So let's go to the fillet, the curve, and let's set the radius for 2. And we want to click all those edges, so there will be 2 over there. Alright, so now we have all of this. I'm going to create the arc, which is the half round shape. It's gonna snapping right here, and then going from this point to this point. Alright, so I have an arc there, and I'm going to copy that one's moving from this endpoint to that endpoint. Okay, so now what I like to do is creating the surface. So let's go into the surface extruded curve straight, and that's extruded this curve from this point to the endpoint where is the radius in. Let's do the other side, starting from the endpoint to the endpoint. Alright, so now we have two. Instead of do everything all over again, I'll go to the top view, rotate it 90 degrees, hold my shift key, and hit the alt key. So now I have those copies. Alright, so the key is how are we going to make everything in between, right? I'm going to divide the center model into the four part, right? That's going to make a straight line, and this is the guideline for how the surface is going to flow. And so we are going to make another line here, all right? And then I'm gonna pick up those two lines and have them split each other. So let's pick up this line and split with this one. So you got that one split. We are going to do one more time. We pick up this line, split by this line. So we have those two straight lines. I'm going to put it into the green color, so it's easier to tell. Okay. Other line we will need is we will need the edge here and here. Okay. So I'm going to use the command. It's called duplicate edge, and I'm duplicate this edges and this edges. Okay. And then they will be split by those two green lines. So now I have this like quarter of the circle. They will be sent to the green layer as well. I also need the bottom one. Instead of trimming, I'm just gonna explode it. Now they are right there in the green layer as well. So let me turn off the rest of the layer so it's easier for you to see this is the green layer. Okay, so for the green layer, we need to creating the surface in between. There's a few things we can think about it, how to create this one. First of all, we can create it by joining those back together and using sweep two, so there will be rail one, rail two from here to there. Let's take a look how it will look. So sweep two, rail one, rail two from here to here. All right. And then very quickly, you kind of notice there's a line in the middle, even though at the starting point is rounded, but because the end you have that point, so that's why you get this pointed edges there. Let's take a render view so it's easier to see. So sweep two in this way, it definitely is not gonna work. All right, so we're gonna delete this and think about other way. If the cone is the point, it's gonna be the problem. What about we don't want that point? All right, so I'm gonna create an arc. It's going to snapping into this endpoint and also snapping into this endpoint, and then I want to move the arc, this third point, to the end of that point, so that will be really symmetrical in this view. Now we want to check from the side view that the arc that we draw is completely flat on the top, right? Because we don't want it to bump, right? So let's take a look if this way will work. We still want to use the sweep to rail, rail one, rail two, you go from the bottom to the top. It should be fine, right? So now we are looking at this. This looks really, really nice. We're gonna click OK. So we got a really nice surface right there. Now the question is how we gonna do the middle part. Before we do that, let's take a look if it's anything stick it out on the top. There's nothing stick it out. So we are going to do is to use the rotate tool and hit zero as the center. And I'm going to make sure on the command bar that copy equal yes. Okay. And holding my shift, click 1, 2, 3, and 4. All right, so now they are connected like this way. All right, let's turn on the blue layer and make sure that they flow really nice. Okay, let's take a look on the render view. All right, so now they seem to look really nice, but look, I still can see the line over there. Right, so that means this doesn't blend with this way. If we take a look on the analyze and then we go into the surface, and then you can have zebra, right? So you pick up this surface, this, and then you hit zebra. And you kind of see they are a little bit off right there, okay? So what is the other way we can work with this surface to make it blend a little bit better? All right, so I'm going to go back to my green and then go back with the step actually. All right, so this is one of the curve there, and actually I'm going to mirror to the other side just for the comparison, okay? And then we're gonna delete this one. We were using this and this as our rail. I'm going to put into the red color. All right, so those two are the rail. What if we reverse and see what happened? We're gonna use the green one as a rail. So that's going to the surface sweep tool. You go here and here, and starting from here, end it there. Okay, so let's take a look, almost identical right there, but let's turn on our layer over there and let's do a comparison. Before we do that, let's hide all the curve and you hide them. Okay, so let's take a look on those and see if they are better. Okay, so I'm going to the surface, analyze, surface, zebra, and let's pick up all this curve at this surface. Let's take a look on it. It seems it match much better. It's because the beginning and end is shared with the same curve, okay? And compared with this one, you can see it's like off a little bit. And let's also take a look on the render view. All right, so this is the one that we just made. As you can see, it's much smoother at this point. And this one, you will see a line, okay? So even though you are using the sweep tool on both of the surface, but because the way you pick on the rail and it indicate where the direction it goes, it actually make a huge difference, okay? So I'm going to delete the old one and we are going to stay with the new one. Okay, now let's go to the top view. We're gonna do the same thing. Gonna go into a rotate, hit on zero, holding the shift, make sure the copy equal yes, and let's go this way. All right, so now we have all of this, right? You might see a little bit of line overlapping because I intended to make my curve a little bit thicker so it will see better. All right, they actually just match. All right, now the surface we can use is the command is right here, surface from 2, 3, 4 edges, right? So I'm gonna pick up 1, 2, 3, 4 and it will create edges, right? So let's take a look on the render view again. So that's the render view. It doesn't look too good at the center because the surface we create is from 2, 3, 4 edges, and you kind of see there's a tiny break there, so it doesn't look good. But we're gonna go back and reevaluate the surface that we make. We're gonna delete this one and we're gonna call out the curve that we made. So right here, let's go ahead to stating with the green one. So the green one that we had this curve, and we also have this curve, all right? So notice that the sweeping in different direction does make the surface like tiny different, but does show in the render. In this case, I'm going to try sweep 2 again. So we are going to explode it, this one, so it become 2 curve. I wanted to do is to make sure the curve is matching the edge of this surface. So let's go to sweep 2, and this gonna be rail 1, rail 2, and pick the edge, surface edge, to be your cross section. So then we will make this surface. Let's turn on the render view to take a look. Seems like it got much better. on this surface to this surface. Okay, so let's take a look and see how it looks for others. So the same command for rotate, and you're gonna snapping into the endpoint, holding your shift, and go from 1, 2, 3, 4, and hit enter. So now look at the render view. It looks much better than what we had before. And let's turn on this. And again, you're gonna select all of them. Select all the curve. And again, you're gonna select all the curve. Just the curve. And we wanna hide it. All right. So just the curve. All right. Sometimes you see this line there, but actually there's no overlapping over there. How do I know? Is you can actually join them, and then this, if it is overlapping, you won't able to join them. So the way I can join them, I know there's no gap. We want to do one more test. Let's go to analyze surface. And let's do zebra again. So this time I want to pick up the whole things and see how things actually flow to each other. All right. Well, again, this surface right there flow really well. We want to see how's the top. And by moving this, you don't see much of the interruption just going there. So I will say this is a good to go for what our purpose here. This is the way I will use for creating really smooth surface without the T-Spline. I hope you enjoy the video. Please like and comment and share my video that helped me on my ranking in YouTube. So that's a way I can keep making free tutorial for you. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next Monday.